Hi friends, my name is Miss Porter. I'm your art teacher. I am so happy to see you all in your brand new classrooms, meeting all your new friends. I'm still at home, but I'm sending you my love, and I have made a very special art project for us to do together this week. Today, we are gonna go on an adventure. So when you leave class today, you are gonna have a work of art that looks sort of like this. You see my little person, and they go dot, 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 dot. They go dot, 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 all these different places. I think I even see a shark. Yours is gonna look different from mine, and that's totally okay. Teachers, our goal today is to see if our artists can differentiate between freely scribbling and making meaningful marks and shapes. Now, scribbles are beautiful too. So if some of our artists don't follow my narrative precisely, that's okay. We want to see wherever this gridded paper takes us, whatever it inspires us to make, we're going to be happy as long as we're drawing and coloring. Our goal is just to see where we are at the start of the year so that by the end we can see how much we've grown. So before we get started, all my friends are going to need their gridded piece of paper in front of them. Teachers, every student's name is written on the back and there's a stamp for the date. I've got mine ready. Do you? Before we get out our crayons, I want to warm up our fingers. So friends, let's read a little story together, and you're going to move your fingers along with my character, Rosie. Do you see Rosie on the cover? Right there. What else do you notice about this cover? Do you see another animal on there? I see this animal here. This is a fox, and I don't think foxes want to be friends with chickens. I think they want to eat them, so we're going to have to move really fast so Rosie doesn't get eaten. Are you ready? Let's get started. Rosie went for a walk. Let's make Rosie like this. One, two, three. One, two, three, and then we're going to close our fingers like that. This is Rosie. Rosie went for a walk across the yard. Let's make her go across the yard. Around the pond. Here's our pond. She's going to go around, so she's not going to touch it. Look what happens to that fox. Over the haystack. There's her haystack. If she goes over, boop, just like that, she hops over. Past the mill. Here's our mill. Past the mill. Through the fence. This will be my fence. Boop. Through the fence. Poor fox. Under the beehives. Here's our beehives. And if she goes under, where does she go? Under. Very good. Watch what happens to that fox. He gets chased away. And Rosie gets back home in time for dinner. Let's give her something good to eat. Very good job. We kept Rosie safe. And she went on her own little adventure, going over, under, around. I think you and I can go on an exciting adventure. Maybe you're gonna go to outer space. Maybe you're gonna go around the neighborhood into a jungle. I can't wait to see what you draw together. But we're going to use the same fingers that we made Rosie. One, two, three. We're going to use these to hold our crayons. Are you ready to draw? Let's get started.